Hello creators! In this video, we'll be learning about the basics of the Free Fire HUD settings. First, let's go over the basic concepts you must grasp before you look into the HUD settings. HUD refers to the information that is shown on the screen during the game, as shown in the video now. HUD informs the player of their current state, such as the weapons they're using, their HP, and the locations of their teammates. The joysticks, menus, etc. are also part of the HUD. Now let's go back to the lobby and tap on HUD settings, create HUD, and create a custom HUD called Custom Interface 1. Then, go to the Edit Layout page and tap on the Background Layer button. There's a default HUD that comes with the game, and the maps will use the default HUD settings when being created. If the default HUD meets the needs of the map, we do not need to customize the HUD. Now, let's get to know about how to customize the HUD in the editor. Now, let's enter the HUD editing layout page. On the left is the hierarchy panel. The hierarchy here refers to the hierarchical relationship between the HUDs. The HUDs we create will be listed in the hierarchy panel in the form of nodes. There are four types of HUDs, or nodes, in the lower left corner. Label is used for entering text. Image illustrates the content of the theme. Button is used for triggering scripts. An empty does not contain any HUD itself, but is simply used to group the HUDs in batch management. Nodes are like the branching points of tree branches, where a single node can give rise to its subordinate nodes. We should note that after we created a HUD, it will be in the selected state by default. When a HUD is selected, the HUDs created after it will become its subordinate nodes by default. You can click on the HUD panel's blank space to cancel the selection of the current node. When no node is selected, the newly created HUDs will become independent nodes. A node can control the content of its subordinate nodes. For example, when we adjust the position of a node, its subordinate nodes will also move with it. On the other hand, moving subordinate nodes does not affect the node they are attached to. This relationship is called the parent-child relationship. We can adjust a HUD with the settings panel on the right, or directly on the hover box that surrounds it. The new HUD we created in the HUD settings is not a completely new interface, but an interface overlaid on the default HUD. So when adjusting, we need to remember to turn on the background layer to avoid the overlapping of the new custom HUD and the default HUD. A custom HUD block is generally used to trigger custom HUD interfaces. Usually, it needs to be matched with the corresponding script to work properly. Return to the lobby and tap the button to enter the logic editor. Let's create a simple script for a HUD interface. We can find the custom HUD block in the game block page. Drag the Create Custom HUD block out. The HUD index parameter here refers to the HUD interface to which the script applies. When there is no custom HUD created, the HUD index would display none by default, which is not tapable. Here we set the HUD parameter index to Custom Interface 1, which is the graphic HUD interface we have previously built. The interface entity parameter on the right refers to the custom HUD, which we do not need to edit. Let's adjust the logic to create a custom HUD, Custom Interface 1, when the player enters the game. Now the script is done. Let's try the script out and see if it can run normally. The test mode must be selected here to trigger the script. The custom HUD appears. So far, we have learned some primary knowledge of the HUD settings in this video. In the process of getting along with the HUD elements, we hope everyone can become familiar with them through practices. Thank you for watching.